thought the brainwashed drones went on a cruise.
Okay, Larry, I'm sure that if we understood what you were talking about, we would agree with you. But for now, just talk about your feelings.
Okay, Abby, all I want is for us to be in love and still have our freedom.
After 28 years, you still want your freedom. Okay. Okay, buddy. You got it.
Hey.
Whoa. Whoa.
Hey. Can I crash with you guys tonight?
We're crashing here.
We are? Mm-hmm. Okay.
Hey, you okay about all this?
Yeah, fine.
We can just go to sleep if you want.
No. No, honey, you've been waiting a long time to break in this bed. Tough out that retainer, you're about to get lucky.
Really?
Let me just call Abby and make sure she got home okay.
Okay.
Hey, Abby, how you doing? Exactly. You want me to hang up? Okay, here's what we're gonna do, okay? Okay, neither one of us are gonna hang up. Okay, we'll just keep the line open all night, and then if you need anything, you just call out, and I'll be right here. Okay? Yeah. Okay, good. Exactly. Okay. Here we go.
Dharma, I can't do this with your mother listening.
I'm not listening.
Oh, this is a delightful situation.
You're the one that let Finkelstein stay in my room.
Oh, Edward, what was I supposed to do? Let him spend the night drooling on my Duncan Fife sofa?
You know, maybe it's time we tell people we're separated and I've moved out of the house.
Edward, we agreed to wait until after the spring social season. We've just accepted too many invitations. Besides, we don't want to traumatize Gregory, do we?
The way you coddled that boy, I'm surprised he didn't grow up funny.
Yes, well, there, but for the grace of your machismo, Edward. Good night.
You know, now that we're spending the night together, how about a little auld lang syne?
Oh, keep your auld lang syne away from me.
I miss Johnny Carson.
Hey, does this smell bad to you?
Dharma, your father is...
Never been able to wear pajamas. He sweats like a wrestler.
Yes, well, la la la, wrestler. Abby, there is a larger issue here. The two of you belong together, not one of you here and one of you traipsing about my kitchen.
I'm sorry, Kitty. He must be driving you nuts.
Oh, please don't say nuts. Abby, I know that, but the two of you don't have what one would consider a traditional relationship. However, you still have a relationship that has lasted 28 years.
29, if you count from when he started watching me with binoculars.
That's it. That's it. Think back to when the romance began. Yes, and we'll call him. We will call him right now. No. I insist. I know it's the right thing to do. Oh, my God. What's going on the other end of this phone? Oh, no.
I'm telling you, Dharma, I heard my mother's voice.
I don't know, Kitty. Maybe I'll call him in a couple of days.
Oh, no. No, 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 no. Listen to me. You just had a fight.
Yeah, well, I'm tired of fighting.
Oh, but fighting is good. At least you still have the passion to fight. Oh, when you lose that, what do you have? You're just making empty dinner conversations, silently fantasizing about the thickly muscled Guatemalan busboy.
Kitty, are you and Edward all right?
Never better. Never better. Every day a second honeymoon. Please don't give up. It's not a good thing to do.
Well, there is nothing like makeup sex.
Pardon me?
You know. Sex after you fight.
Oh, yes, yes, indeed. Oh, it's hot, hot, hot.
Hey.
Hey, what are you doing up?
I can't sleep. How about you?
Well, Greg's hearing voices, so I thought I'd make him some French toast.
That's what your mother always does when I hear him.
I know.
So, you think I should marry your mother?
Larry, I can't tell you what to do with your life.
Yeah, you're right. I understand. Oh, come on. Give me a hint.
All you need to do is follow your heart.
That's not a hint. That's a greeting card.
Okay. There were times when I was growing up when I wished you guys were married. Like that time in ballet class when all the kids called me the graceful little bastard.
That wasn't the name of the ballet?
Swan Lake.
Ah.
But then there were times when I was really proud of you guys for doing your own thing.
Okay. I'll figure it out.
I know you will.
Which way do you think I'll go? Hey, Katie saw me naked.
Me too.
Hi.
Hi.
Hey, Greg, about those voices in your head? Don't answer them. That's what they want.
Oh, you're all up.
Abby.
Larry, Abby has something that she wants to say to you, and then everyone can go home.
No, no, this time, let me go first. Abby, I know it hasn't always been easy living with a passionate revolutionary, a lone wolf tilting at the windmills of America, Inc., a man who...
Focus.
Right.
Oh, my God.
Larry Rome. Oops. Abby O'Neill, would you please...
Oh, it smells so good.
Larry's proposing.
Really? It smells like French toast.
Keep going, Larry.
Abby O'Neill, you've been my friend and lover for 28 years. Now, would you please be my wife?
Oh, my God.
Yes. Yes, she said yes, I heard. Yes! Yes!
My parents are going to be married. That's great.
It's wonderful.
So when's the big day?
Well, I don't think I want to, like, rush into anything, do you, Larry?
No, I wouldn't mind being engaged for a while.
Yeah, we'll give it a few years and see how it goes.
Come on. Let's go home. Thanks for the road, big guy. You won't. Three times a lady. I love yes, you won't. Why?
I love.